I think Senator Lanza spoke quite eloquently on what is perceived as an attempt to politicize or give opportunity to politics to intervene with a grand jury system. Mm-hmm. Many years ago, I also made presentations to the grand jury as an assistant district attorney. We did several of them. Now, I want to ask you, though, specifically some questions. You talk about this independent monitor, right? Mm-hmm. Who would appoint the independent monitor? Where would his qualifications? Could be another DA. Could it be?
Yes.
Should it be?
Yes.
I think this governor is up to his ears with taking care of state business and budgets and laws. And now he wants to take the time to get involved in grand jury processes throughout the state of New York. That, to me, seems a reach, all in the quest of public trust, the perception of public trust, just like he wants to make Albany more ethical. And these are noble quests, don't get me wrong, but extremely difficult, always elusive. Mm-hmm. And do you ever get the result that you're hoping to get in improved trust? So I just, it's like Don Quixote chasing windmills. But let me come back to the qualifications. District attorneys, as I understand it, are not allowed to talk about what the grand jury did.
Correct.
Okay. So do you think a step in the right direction for transparency would be to allow a district attorney to talk about the process?
That's actually a part of the governor's proposal. Exactly right.
Well,
under the proposal, the governor is advising, or a part of the proposal would be to allow a district attorney to release relevant documentation, redacted, of course, in appropriate places, relevant information to the public, advising on a specific type of case. And again, these are only limited to fatality cases, where there's a fatality and there is no indictment or there's no presentment to the grand jury. The district attorney would have the authority to issue a statement or to issue actual minutes or charges to the public for review. That currently does not exist, and that is now going, that is a part of the governor's proposal.
Well, as I understand it, the district attorneys may embrace that proposal to be able to talk, bringing more transparency to the process. What I always marveled at with the grand jury system was that it was the peers that made the decision. In those cases that were controversial, there were minority people in the grand jury, mm-hmm. an assortment of African Americans, assortment of Hispanics and women and Caucasians from the community, judging, you know, whether something should go forward or not. So what this governor is suggesting by this proposal is that he is giving an opportunity to create a political situation, respond to a political situation, whether it's media hype, and you know how the media is today, and whether it's mob justice as a result of community activists that get a lot of attention, trying to distort or get an edge in the grand jury system. Mm-hmm. But these are all of these emotions that are in play by this proposal, and I'm concerned that it doesn't have a good ending. But let's say it got traction. Let's talk out loud a minute. Why wouldn't the independent monitor, if it ever got that far, and I for one don't think it should get that far, why wouldn't it be another DA?
It could be.
Well, why wouldn't it be mandated another DA?
Why
don't we say a district attorney from another county, if you had to have an independent monitor, someone that knows the business,
absolutely,
that's not involved in politics.
Absolutely. That is exactly what the governor is considering. The independent monitor is not outlined in the Article 7 because we thought it may be a retired judge, a criminal court judge. It may be a district attorney who's retired. It could be another district attorney who's actually active. The concern with using an active district attorney is you may potentially create conflicts in the future if that district attorney ends up serving as a special prosecutor in another case or in a similar case. But there's no opposition to using a district attorney as the independent monitor.
Well, you're saying there's no opposition, but the chances, I mean, it's so broad, anything can happen. It could be a community activist, could be a monitor, under the definition, am I right?
It's not defined in the
bill. Right, it's not defined.
Yes. So we could essentially define it to create parameters to address that concern.
One of the concerns that I see happening at the national level and the state level is that political decisions are determining public policy when that shouldn't be such a strong and overpowering factor. Mm-hmm. And that's where this proposal is going. I thank you. You spoke very well, by the way, in the proposal. But for one that's watched this grand jury system for almost 50 years, I think it works. Nothing is perfect. Nothing is perfect. But for the most part, it works very, very well, and it's not politicized. I like the idea of a DA being able to have more transparency to talk about it. But it's always the decision is made by the peers of the community without the political process. And whether the perception of trust or not trust is out there, I think it'll always be out there. But I want the peers deciding whether someone is guilty or not. And I thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator. I'll just briefly, a postscript to that. I think we agree. There's no, again, and I want to make sure that we're being crystal clear about what the governor's proposal does. The Attorney General has a proposal that he's advanced. The Chief Judge has advanced a proposal as well. And objectively speaking, I think that the governor's proposal is well balanced because it increases transparency and accountability, allows the district attorneys to release information as appropriate, and also informs the governor's process without inflating the process or without providing additional powers to the governor. Otherwise, what we have is, in my opinion, a much more politicized process and uninformed process as well.